burning bush. This was when God was trying to get him to actually lead the people through the Red Sea into freedom, trying to lead them out of their lives of oppression under a militant government. And Moses, like any good leader in the Bible, was trying to weasel his way out of it. He was buddy-fing with God, trying to say no, but God persisted and ended up calling a reluctant and fearful and faithful Moses, reminding him that God would be with him through the whole thing. Now, just in case you thought that when they went through the Red Sea, the great Exodus happened, that then they were free, I mean, they were, but it takes a long time, right? The Exodus was something that took a long, long time, because to free generations of oppression takes generations. So today, we meet up with Moses and the freed Israelites 40 years later. Freedom takes a lot of work, right? So shortly before Moses dies, and it's before they actually reach the land that was promised to them, and Moses finds himself having to repeat himself yet again, the Ten Commandments. Now, in his defense and in the people's defense, he's actually having to tell the people, the children of the people that he freed, right? These are now people that were born during this wilderness wandering time, okay? It's not the original people that followed him out of exile. These are their children now that he is leading. And he is reminding them that God's promises still ring true. Yeah, and he kind of has to make a case that the covenant, the promise, still stands. Because the Ten Commandments were revealed in Exodus 20, but now he's having to repeat them. And did you catch this? He says in verse 2, "The Lord our God made a covenant with us at Horeb, not with our ancestors," he says, "not with our ancestors did the Lord make the covenant, but with us, who are all of us here alive today." So perhaps the subtext of what he is saying is, listen, I know you weren't actually alive when this all started, and you didn't hear the first round of the Ten Commandments, but it's still true. It's like he's saying, hey you in the back, listen up, this counts. You here right now alive, right? So just as I try to make the case week in and week out, that, hey guys, the Bible's still relevant. This is our story and God's story, right? Week in and week out. Well, now I think their frustration would be legitimate. I mean, they've been homeless and on the move for 40 years. That's all these children of the exile have known, and they're, you know, children that are my age now, I suppose. So I imagine they're doubting the promise of the land of milk and honey as they're confronted with hunger and continued wilderness wandering. I imagine that they look around and they're like, this is not what I imagined freedom would look like. So Moses reminds them that it's in living that they are free, and that the Ten Commandments free us to live. Now sometimes, I don't know what your experience is like, but sometimes, you know, when you see the big monuments of the Ten Commandments, right? They can look like embarrassing, frozen in stone, a relic to a bygone era, right? They can look tone deaf. They can look like a list of rules inflicted on undeserving, unappreciative people. They can look outdated and irrelevant. They can look like wishful thinking, especially when they are reduced to just a list of rules. But I don't think that's what they're for. The Ten Commandments aren't just a list of rules. I think that's a thin reading of them. And you know, we were told in the scripture today to not, he didn't say, remember them in your brains. Make rational sense out of these Ten Commandments. He said, remember them and keep them in your heart. And when you remember and keep them in your heart, you're more able and ready to live them and then to have that be taught to those around you, including your children. But man, we often relegate the Ten Commandments as a list of don'ts. Don't worship other gods. Don't swear. Don't work on the Sabbath. Don't be rude to your parents. When in reality, it is about our freedom. It's a list that helps give us life, that tells us what to do instead of what not to do. Now, poor Justin Bieber. He has to grow up on a global stage. I mean, that's tough, right? And he's been making the news recently. I'm not